So, about a month ago, I had a session with Hinaldo Ribeiro, who is an absolutely amazing technician. He showed me some really cool De La Hiva stuff. I'll link it. After that, we had a roll where he completely demolished me. So today we're going to have a look at that, and I am going to narrate it and say, we sort of point out some of the stuff that I should have done better. He's extremely good. It's like I'm just half a second too slow on everything. And my balance wasn't keeping up with his, or and I couldn't get my grips going. Everything. Well, you'll see. By far one of the best that I've rolled with. So I hope you enjoy. So off we go. So I try to get a pant grip and a lapel grip, and I get worried about his leg, so I abandon the grip, which was actually really good. Here I try to strip his grip, but he's got really good grips, really strong grips. So I'm working on the underhook so that I could start working my pass. He's got this butterfly hook in, which is annoying me. So I tried to sort of pin his leg, and then I was going to go for a leg drag, but he just Shaolin sweeps me and gets on top. And here I want to sort of get to a coyote guard kind of thing, and but his knee is too far forward. I try to off balance him, and we end up in this half guard with him on top. He's got super heavy hips, trying to get my hook in here, and it's not really working. I think he's got really heavy shoulder pressure, like Shoulder of Justice. He gets the underhook. Oh, I've almost got, but not quite. And then he goes back and manages to flatten me out. Pins my leg, and then he goes for the mat. My arm is stuck underneath, and he goes for the straight armbar, and that's it. And that's the first roll, and it was really that quick. Now, we're not going balls to the wall, but I'm still trying. He's got really strong grips, so I try to clear the grips. You can see his head positioning is really good. And I'm trying to sort of get under and change the angle because I'm being put off by his head positioning. I try to stand up, and then I realize that I don't really want to stand up with him. Again, so I pull guard. And we end up, I've got a quarter guard here. It's not really good. My wrist can't, I can't use the right wrist properly, so I can't use it to lift him with either. Now from here I need his foot a little back so I can get under to work the sweep, or I need to get up on my knees, and he gets the underhook, so he's using that to flatten me out. I thought maybe I could stuff both his legs and get like a mermaid kind of sweep going, and again he pins my arm and starts working for the cross collar. I'm going for the upa. He's wiser. He switches to like a S mount, and then at this point I kind of know I'm fucked. And there we go. And so at this point I realise I don't want to be on top, so I'm trying to get on top. I want to control the inside, and you can see he puts my arm on the outside. So I'm thinking that maybe I can go for a leg drag, but he gets my right arm, which stuffs that. And here we go. He goes for the De La Hiva thing. You can't see it, but that's exactly the thing that we were doing, which is in the description. Just getting ready. I think he's tapped me, what, three or four times at this point. But he's being extremely nice about it. So I try to control his grips, and he's better at grip fighting than I am. And now I want to get head positioning because his head positioning was so good. I don't really want to stand up with him. And he pulls guard and goes for like a an omoplata straight. I'm trying to roll out. Oh, I managed to roll out. And I don't quite make it up. I give up turtle and I go for like an octopus sweep, which I managed to do. So here I try to do a throw by. I don't get as far as I could. I should have circled all the way to north-south, and I end back up in his guard. He's got like a keymaster, and he scissor sweeps me perfectly. He gets the gift wrap. I knew I was done at that point with the bow and arrow thing he had going. So I tapped maybe a little prematurely. There wasn't a lot to do though. I'm trying to control his grips and then I keep my head under his. So it didn't work being on top, so I try pulling guard and I end up in this half butterfly where he's sort of already past one of them. I'm trying to straighten him out so that I can get my other hook in, and that just results in him heavy hipping his way out of that and just passing quickly. He gets to a strong side control. It's very old school classic, pulling up the lapel there to keep the side control, and then he starts working like a cross collar choke, which worked. So I'm trying to count the amount of submissions at this point. I go again. He's nice. He pulls guard and kind of just lets me get my grips. And then he strips them straight away. I was gonna go for some Ruotolo, kind of pinning the leg with my foot. Now you can see he's got the inside with his left hand, so I'm trying to go heavy hips and sprawl on it, and that just resulted in him doing that, switching to the omoplata. Now I can't roll, so I'm sort of trying to sit back a little so that I won't be flattened out, and he gets it. And here I lean back, which is a major mistake when you go for a butterfly. I'm trying to control this slip, his sleeve. I sit up, and here I should have been moving a bit faster. I let him move towards my back, which was not wise. And again, like a bow and arrow thing, he doesn't even have his leg in, it's still there. That's very cool. Last one. I try to control his posture. He's so good with the grips, and they're so hard to strip. He's got such a good open guard. He's controlling the sleeve. I'm trying to make. And he hip bumps me. And that's it. And he was just playing around. Really good roll. Got absolutely destroyed. Oh well, that's it. Thank you for watching.